see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see.
And then handicapped people, they need to have gone to be able to go and enjoy our YC program on the third floor, performing art, and then second floor. So we need an elevator. So we are trying very best and to raise money. And that's what we have during the September show. This is the last one. To thank those who help us grow. Now, what's happened with the president? Anyhow, I just wanted to share with you what this center is all about. If I mention about the mission statement of the WAH Center, WAH Center, WAH means in Japanese peace, harmony, and unity. Here you are, a cane, belated Paul Picard. So how long you get us waiting? You have to apologize.
I didn't realize it was a...
Yuko, Todd, thank you both so much for having me. I just had the opportunity to meet Yuko about 2 weeks ago, and I've never played my music in front of people I don't know, so this is going to be interesting. I've only played it in front of people about twice, so I'm
a... Lost a brother, gained a wife, and boredom took its stride. Thank you.
hard earned loving, which is trying to find a girlfriend and not being able to.
was drowning in Lake Michigan. There's no telling what could happen because I am afraid of getting into the water. It makes me nauseous. She claims she is fine, and after a moment, I yell, "You don't want me to be worried about you?" But she is too caught up in waves to answer. The flies on the beach won't stop pestering me. I am rolling around in sand, dirty and longing for someone who doesn't want me. Jess tells me to reason with them, as if persuasion could lead me to be left alone happily. What if I want to be tormented, teased and unraveled until I spill out answers the mind secretly knows? Everything feels saturated. I say there is no God, but the sky looks like heaven at sunset, brimming with...
Thank you. But CBS News did this. They said it.
These are things that people want to know. That's why they're watching us. That's why they're here, tuning in to the 24-hour marathon, Williamsburg Art Historical Center live call-in elevator fundraising show. Alex, I have a question for you. How much do you think an elevator costs for a building like this?
I did not research that.
$100, $200, what are we, $4,000 maybe. Well, thankfully, we have the president of the Williamsburg Art and Historical Center here with us, Dr. Todd Picard. Todd, give him a round of applause. Why don't you come over here? Thank you, President. Thanks so much. Just a couple personal questions. How much does it cost to have an elevator? How much does the elevator cost?
A lot.
So, thanks so much. Give it up for President. We'd like to kind of, it can feel elitist talking about elevators, but elevators are everywhere, and you may have seen them in pop culture. You may have seen an elevator in a movie, in a TV show, even if you've never ridden in one. We want to capture that feeling, so we're going to read a scene, an elevator scene from the famous 1994 rom-com You've Got Mail. We need two volunteers from the audience to join us for this four-person scene. Just come on up. Don't even raise your hand. Just come on up. I'm gonna get the people that I see who are most awkward if no one comes up. Okay, I'm gonna take you, sir. Come on up. And you, man. Yes. That's what it's just.
Thank you. I really like your pants.
Thank you so much. You guys can grab around. So I'm gonna be playing the role of Joe Fox, and Alex will be playing the role of his.
We only have one script. We got it.
You're also grab around. Alex will be playing the role of the elevator doorman.
Charlie.
What's her name? Katya. I would like you to play the part of Patricia and Ben. And you'll be playing Veronica. Okay?
get in.
Hello, Charlie, Veronica.
Last time, we broke in an elevator. We made the deal of the century. What is going to happen this time?
Miss Grant's going to get me a part in one of her movies. That's what's going to happen.
In your dreams, Charlie.
The elevator suddenly stops.
Yeah.
history professor at the Fashion Institute of Technology. And I just thought it was fantastic. The elevator industry's lack of support for the Elevator Historical Society is typical of a lack of vision that goes back more than 150 years, he said. The elevator industry could help save the world, but it hasn't tried enough. That was great. I got the agent. So much. We will call back at 9 a.m. on Monday when we resume the 24-hour, 48-hour, 72-hour, 96.
coming out so far. He's like mad into it.
Okay.